Hello. Someone please mute their phone. We cannot hear the conversation.
Mute on.
What amount of
The approach for the is actually sports sector is such that you saw the dumping pairing right 160.
The contract. Yes, sir, the contract.
Correct. And then also we have to take in consideration we are having a rock side with a high frequency motion. So I mean, the SRP 3.72 basically, because at this case you shift the responses to the right, it is conservative to use ANCRA, the full stiffness property. Now,
for ISR,
right.
So ISR development, you don't have to consider it.
Actually, we went.
So I don't know what's your
right.
They did the OB plus uncrack as the base case. Then they did the OB plus the cracked.
So
SAE plus the cracked.
Which I don't have issue.
Then the in if the you stay with the
two additional.
Yeah, that's
fine. The only thing
there's only collected 10%. If the extension is larger than 10, they will invalid. If it's below 10, they'll forget about it. I think there's some discussion in either your RA response or in the report is that the reason they use 10% is because for the cracked model, they are taking credit of the full cracked property. Actually, in reality, the structure never, you know, develop a full cracking everywhere. So that 10%, that explanation is perfect for me. So it
right.
Didn't see here, but I remember
so
it. Yeah.
Basically, it's one of your old questions. So, it's
so basically, more of a conservative compared to the extracted approach.
Yes.
Yeah, I just want to make sure that that's the comfortable. I don't want that bring the question.
Yeah, it's a slide 75.
Generate a new question.
Before I move on, I can just say, because here you only talk about the sensitivity study about the stiffness variation. You didn't talk about the triple SI.
The reactor building.
For this reactor building, is that saying that the triple SI effect on reactor building is negligible, or you didn't consider?
That is correct. That is a DCD stand, actually. Basically, reactor building is, we looked at the triple SI effects, but reactor building on control building, because reactor building is much, by far larger structure. So there was no never in the DCD nor in the site-specific application. For the site-specific analysis, that we looked the other way around.
So you look at the effect of the cheap Wi-Fi on reactor building?
No, on the control building.
Control
reactor building.
On the...
Right. Because, like, the effect of the CB on the reactor building is negligible.
No, okay.
Right.
So you didn't see it again, because the question says both cases for stiffness variation on the also cheap Wi-Fi. But in your answer,
right.
I didn't see that, but I don't understand.
Yes.
The RB is much heavier than control building, so the effect is minimal. Or
yes, yes, and that was the basis in the DCT.
Okay, but the sensitivity is basically same thing, you know, the 10% criteria is uniform criteria, right, on all the buildings.
Right, we are using 10% basically as a criteria for all the sensitivity studies, now or maybe in the future, if there's anything to do. But in terms of us, we recognize that, for example, the cracking can amplify some modes which are not there in the uncracked model, so basically we wanted to capture that, which we went a step further than what are the requirements, if you don't see something.
Okay. I understand this tab earlier as the justification for the use of 10% as the criteria. If student is 5%, then you ignore the endolocking. Other analysis.
But you're talking only structural response paper when you have a small peak exceeding 5%.
Yes. Not broad or something.
Right, right. But in terms of loads, no, we don't use any criteria. I mean, if it exceeds, it is what I have written in the slides, if you can go back, we are in the open. So whatever structural evaluation we are doing right now, it's in the local.
This is Joe Braverman. I have a question, if you could clarify something. For the control building and the FWSC structure, in your response you indicate that you make a comparison of the sensitivity analysis results with the design basis. You look at load demand in particular FSAR sections. So looking at those sections, it's not clear if you also use this comparison and enveloping for stability evaluation and soil bearing pressure and lateral wall pressure below grade.
For sensitivity analysis, especially cracking, first we go and we look at the loads and in structural response spectra when we do the sensitivity analysis. And based on this sensitivity analysis, only the case of the effect of control building of fire water service complex was significant. I mean, it's not large, but it was significant. And that's why we have included a triple SI analysis, fire water service complex control building into our design basis. Now, the cracking, if you look at the loads, yes, we have few slabs that exceed the loads, for example, due to cracking or stiffness variation effects, but the overall loads are considerably lower, maybe 40%. So, we did not evaluate like stability evaluation for the crack case because the overall load is considerably lower. Just
but how much pressure is it? Did you look at it, please?
For the dynamic pressure on the walls, what we have observed, soil case, there's not much of variation between them. I think you look at the results, they are not documented for the pressures, and they were also very close.
You didn't have asking me the SSI, you know, in between you have some oil or something. Can increase here sometimes.
Also for triple SI, absolutely, we are looking at the pressures, and we look from, for example, between reactor building effects and control building. Reactor building, yes, amplifies, yeah. And for triple SI, we always look at the, because it's an important issue in the triple SI.
So does that answer your question?
Well, kind of. Maybe we could proceed further during the audit as long as there's a technical explanation whether you enveloped the sensitivity results or you did not include them as well for stability, soil bearing pressure, and wall pressure below grade. Hopefully you either enveloped it or you have a technical basis for not doing so.
Okay.
Okay.
Does that mean yes?
Yes, we have taken a basic source for certain cases, yeah. Yes, we've looked at it.
Okay, but
not
like you're
going to
look at it all your time?
No, no, no.
We don't want to have something that's lingering.
No, all the laws we use is envelope, basically.
No, it's just talking about stability analysis.
All the stability analysis, we looked at it, honestly, it didn't really make sense. No, there were some cases we did, but we never document them, because I don't think looking at the shear force diagrams from the cracked and uncracked case for each of the buildings, you see there is a huge de-amplification or reduction of the response due to the cracking. And for control building, for example, it's like more than 50%.
I think if you consider cracking, it should be favorable for the...
Oh, yes, absolutely.
I just want to make sure you actually have done the analysis in a way that can look at it and make some comparison. You know, I mean, this is the only audit for targets. Okay, let me ask you. I don't want to go there and my staff over here to complain.
I mean, for the stability analysis, I think the technical justification, what we can provide you is just refer to the graphs we have in Appendix B of each of the reports, seeing how much the shear force demands and vertical force shear force demands are reduced by considering lower stiffness. So based on their justification, we can go with it. And I think, in my opinion, it's sufficient. I don't know if you need more than
we
that.
We can check that. I think on the triple SSI, you did analysis for the impact of the lateral dynamic pressure on the wall.
And you have a section, right?
Yeah, you have section. You have a detailed discussion of those what document accidents, all kind of stuff. So I think that's okay. What you asked for is you did not provide analysis for the soil bending pressure. That's what you asked.
From a triple SSI analysis?
Yeah, from triple SSI. So you will provide those kind of impacts. Impact in your audit?
So you're talking about the contact pressure, the yeah. Contact ratio evaluation? We have to discuss it. I mean, to have it documented by then, it might
because be. Because the same model that we already have.
But I thought our question, but the little question was the resolve.
Yeah. I
hope we don't get
a resolve. Did you guys want to think about it as an action item before we leave?
Yes, it is important.
I mean, I would rather move the audit out to allow you to finish it and then be able to support it than to go there and have to go back again.
I don't want to do an audit to start engaging this type of discussion, right? Render the information
the issue is about documenting everything and going through the
That's important because it's important to us. And the audit is not the platform to resolve the issues. So we go there basically to confirm the position you provided in the response to the technical report that support with the calculation.
Just one clarification. So basically, you want to look at the triple SSI effects on the bearing pressure under the foundation and the contact ratio.
Sometimes soil pressure may be a low frequency. Sometimes I have seen that.
Can I summarize it a little differently? You know, I looked at the very stability reports, which account for a sliding stability, soil bearing pressures, and also lateral pressures on walls below grade. In some cases, you incorporated the sensitivity results and enveloped them. In other cases, I think you were silent. So if you could go back and confirm that where you did not envelope the cases, do you have a technical basis for not doing so?
Yes.
You follow?
Yes.
Okay, so that would be your action item.
Does Joe, between what Joe and Lubin said, does that satisfy all of the reviewers' questions regarding this topic, or is there something else that we need to consider as we're looking at what is and isn't documented?
The 10% question is up in
the so far, I still haven't heard even one on my side comment on the 10%.
Right, we're still.
It is acceptable to me.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So they have a.
If they did the base case, OBE with some crack model, that should be acceptable. That's our regard solution.
Yeah.
Right, if they do an additional, I think it's always good. You didn't do that for loading?
No, for loading, no. All the exceedances there.
No, if they're doing it for loading, that would be problematic.
Okay.
It would also be structurally problematic.
You're okay, George, with 10%? Okay.
And also you check the displacements.
Yes, and there are some cases that crack cases because the treatment goes slower and larger, and then the design will consider.
Okay.
So the only outstanding question on this topic is the one that Joe asked.
He summarized.
Yeah, right. That's
right.
I think the only action you guys have is you have a sensitivity study to provide a basis for why you did not use the envelope for stability, the bearing pressure, that sort of pressure. That's your action. Hopefully, it provides something that is curate the analysis.
And the technical basis, would you like that to be in the report included?
Why is it important or not? It's an REI response.
As I said, in the final thing, we look at the books. Make our safety
determination. I'd just like to adjust the enforce not a big request. But, the envelope of the foundation pressure and the lateral pressure thing is also affected to the impact point of the fall. So that to me that the result that we will look at very carefully, but for the 2x4 we also need to make it clear what the proper value is for the lateral foundation.
So if I understand well, if you want to connect the section 2.5.4 with what is in that.
You provide a clear justification and to the whistle and out that way for yourself, you will be very popular information.
You can also consider, you know, have some markup, any downstream effect will not work, right? Just make sure you have some.
Any number change will affect the 2.5 and the 4. But in your document, the markup you need to consider that.
For example, in the case of a bearing pressure, that is the developed from SSI or triple SI analysis. My understanding is that if there is any impedance of a design basis based on SSI, the oil exceedance is from triple SI or sensitivity analysis within the envelope there. In the case of soil pressure calculation, just enveloping, not just applying 10% threshold. If there's any exceedance, all those exceedances will be enveloped in determining final soil pressure to be used in 2.5.
Correct. The 10% criteria applies only for mean fracture response spectra and peak exceedances.
Could you go over the other bullets in this
one? You're right. So maybe we can go to control building.
So we don't need to go back to 7575, which
is about there, is there anything different in your second ISRS for design and recruitment? Adjustable slab wall.
Okay, for the whole buildings, what we do is we end up with the results of craft and anchor. And then if we have a triple SI exceedance, now it's a little bit different. For the control effect, control building, there's no significant exceedances due to triple SI on the load. So basically, there was a different question. We said we are going to address that in the EFSA. Now, if we have, for example, exceedances on the infrastructure response spectra due to the triple SI, you notice one which is 25%, that is reactor building on the control building. Then in that case, you asked us for justification. We were using as a justification incoherency because we are not considering. So basically, we think we can, we will end all of that. So how we are going to do that, we are not going to end all of the results, but we will calculate, because we never run analysis, triple SI analysis with the crack model, in order to capture both effects, and we are going to scale the spectra for the difference. For example, with the exceedance of 25% at certain frequency, we are going to amplify the spectra for 25%.
Basic design.
Right, right. So the same applies for the firewater service complex. Firewater service complex, what is design basis, as I said before, because the triple SI effects from the control building were in a way significant, they were included in design basis. So what you have as a design basis includes triple SI effects on the firewater service complex. Now, we did also sensitivity study for the cracking, and we observed a few small exceedances in the loads, for example, and also for the spectra. In that case, also we are scaling rather than just enveloping the results, because we never run triple SI analysis with the crack model for firewater service. So that is the only difference that we have. And I think I explained that in slide 120, how we're going to do the most effects we saw is for the spectra on the slabs, the axial slabs. So the approach is the same what we are going to use for the...
we'll scale it up, basically.
Correct.
We have to look at the details.
For the cracking will be envelope, and then for in order to take in account, and that's really one isolated case when we had exceedance of the infraction response spectra of the basement response. So that one will be scaled. For firewater service complex, basically the triple SI are folded in the design basis.
Can I ask to explain this a little bit more? When you consider what yeah. happened to the other picture too, you said by amplifying the design as well as using the ratio of results obtained from triplets analysis of this combined model and corresponding S analysis. Just, you know, elaborate a little bit, what do you mean by the ratio of results? Is that equivalent to just the inverse of the two, or not equivalent?
No, basically the design spectra we have already in the right now, the report, first we are going to take care of the cracking effect.
Okay.
And then we overall of the results. Now, we observe some amplification on the from the triple SI analysis.
Okay.
Which, and then you will look what is the maximum amplification we get, and we apply that on the design spectrum.
Using frequency by frequency, or you use one factor, apply the
unit? No, it is frequency dependent. Right.
Frequency dependent.
Right.
So the ratio, basically, you take the ratio of the triple SI analysis over the SS analysis result. Use that factor with the frequency dependent factor.
Correct.
And you apply that factor to the result of the SS result. So
correct.
To me, it's mathematically equivalent to inverse two.
Yes, the only thing is that we also will consider the Bodenin effect.
A Bodenin effect.
Right.
Okay, good.
Because we look at the circle case, you know, there might be some amplification on the other case. For the triple SI analysis of control building and reactor building, we're just looking three circle cases, not all of them. So basically, there is some amplification. I mean, we look at that, most probably it will be the equivalent to end level thing at the end, but we want to...
Yeah, and none better now, so
right.
The reason you didn't invert, but use, you know, use the factor to amplify the one, because you didn't do all the soil cases. Because if you do all the soil cases, invert is fine, but if you only do a few or three, invert you can miss something. But if you use the application factor, you potentially can capture the other cases you didn't do the analysis.
That is correct.
Thank you.
So I have a question to her. So basically, so you are saying that makes the man...
Hey, George, could you tell them which
page 190. So your seismic demand, your threshold is 3% across board. So if less than 3%, that you ignore it. Beyond 3%, you will be included in that.
I mean, we don't use 3%. Per se. Like the 10% criteria is a criteria we apply for all sensitivities. 3% here is like... it's a numerical noise, you know. Plus minus. I'm not talking overall. Everything is 3% higher. It is up to.
That we have some.
Right.
We have more than much more than those. So I just understand what the design basis for the whole seismic demand design. So like here, you have the SSI, the design basis, and you have triple SSI. So the existence, how much exceedance will be included in the design basis? Also, you have debris analysis. So all this. So you combine all together. So I need to figure out what your final design basis for design. That's the math.
For design?
That's the criteria that I see here in so 3%.
No, this was a conclusion in the CBRBAB report that the effects on the loads can be neglected. We looked, and basically there was a discussion, and there is another question, I believe, 8, then we are going to put in the effort this conclusion from the triple SI analysis that those are small. And we have justification when we see the exceedance in the load, why we don't have to consider. Either they were enveloped by the DCD load or they are like on the locations which are not really important for the design. And that is in the CBRBFD report conclusion.
Does that answer your question, George?
The land is going to be marked. Actually, 3% is not a criteria. The 3% observation, when they compare the triple SS result with the SS result, mostly the SS result are invalid for the triple SS result. Only for a few cases that the triple SS result exceeds the SS result with 3% or less. So in this case, you say this is a negative engineer adjustment. That's really not a criteria.
Okay.
And I mean, Site 122 describes how we are going to deal with firewater service complex with tax response platforms. Here we have one oscillator for the fire pump enclosure, the roof. We had to add an oscillator in the truck model, and then this is oscillator 13.